Good morning. Here to honor Mr. Lee this morning. I promise I will be brief for you this morning. I won't bore you or keep you long. Mr. Thomas Larry Lee, 78, passed away March 3rd, 2022 at Orange Park Medical Center following an extended illness. He was born in Manor, Georgia to the late Thomas H. Dick Lee and Lillian Nadine Pittman Lee. He retired from the trash department with the city of Waycross. In addition to his parents, he was also preceded in death by his sister, Diane Merritt, and three brothers, Ricky Lee, Freddie Lee, and Emmanuel Lee. He is survived by four children, Thomas Larry Lee Jr. of Waycross, Tammy J. Lee of Douglas, Melissa D. Lee, Gary Andrews of Waycross, and Carol D. Lee of Waycross, three grandchildren, Dylan Grover, Dalton Grover, and Jalen Lee, and a great-grandson, Asher Lee, six siblings, Rebecca Joyner of Mississippi, Lizzie Dilbert of Douglas, Pam Lee of Mississippi, Grover Lee of Waresboro, Chris Lee of Waycross, Matt Lee of Waycross, and numerous nieces and nephews. Let us pray one more time. Heavenly Father, we come to you as humble as we know how, just thanking you for your blessings, God. Even in a time like this, we understand that there are blessings, God. Lord, it's a rough time, it's a dark time, but God, I pray that your peace and your comfort, God, and your Holy Spirit would cover this family, God. Lord, as only you can, God. We can't do it by ourselves, God. No man can give us that peace, only you, God. Lord, we just thank you for this day, God, and we ask, God, that you would just help us to remember the good times today, God, and we just thank you for what you've already done. It's your name we pray. Amen. I want to read a passage of scripture, probably very familiar to you. The book of Romans, chapter 8, and verses 31, it says, "What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord." I was talking with the family a little bit last night. I was trying to get some interest that Mr. Lee was interested in, and she told me that fishing, and I'm sure if he loved fishing, he was a true fisherman, so I'm sure that y'all have heard the stories of how one time a fish was this big, and the next time he told the story, the fish had grown that big. That is a true fisherman. That's how stories go. The fish is never the same size. He loved fishing. He loved NASCAR. He loved wrestling. That's a pretty cool guy, if you ask me. I could get in. I could watch all those and do all those. And I asked him to describe Mr. Lee. And this is where I got this scripture from. A gentle soul who would help anybody give the shirt off of his back. Doesn't that sound like who Jesus is? Doesn't that sound like a good representation of Jesus and what he does for us? I can't preach somebody's funeral. I don't preach funerals. You preach your funeral while you are alive, the way you treat people, the way you love people. And just like she said, a gentle soul who would help anybody and get a shirt off his back. That's who he was. That he preached that to people who knew him, and even the people who didn't know him, I'm sure he helped them out. That's who Jesus is. And we see right here in verses 31 that if God be for us, who can be against us? God loved us enough that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. We all know that verse by heart. We've heard that all of our lives. Jesus loved us so much that he said, you can conquer and you can overcome anything in this world. And I want to, just for a few moments this morning, talk to you on the subject of the inseparable love. No matter what you've done, no matter where you've been, no matter what you go through, Jesus loves you. No matter how many times you fall, no matter how many times you make mistakes, and let me tell you something, I don't care. The best Christian in this world is going to make mistakes. No matter how perfect we try to act, we all fail. We all fall short. That's why he said, if God be for us, who can be against us? No matter how many times you fall down, God still loves you. He's still there to pick you up. He said in the book of 1 John, that if any man sin, he has an advocate with the Father. So when you fall down, when you make mistakes, you get back up, you keep going. In a time like this, it's hard. There's going to be many firsts. There's going to be first Thanksgivings, first Easters, first Christmases. There's going to be a lot of firsts without Mr. Lee. But I can promise you one thing, with the help and by the grace of God, you can make it through. One more verse I want to point out this morning, verse 37. In all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. We are more than conquerors. It doesn't matter what you face. Life is hard. Life is rough. And I'm sure Mr. Lee faced many rough battles in his life. But by the grace of God, he made it through. And by the grace of God this morning, you as well can make it through. Not to sugarcoat anything this morning, we know life is rough. If you're sitting in this building this morning, you know that life is rough. Life throws curveballs. Life throws us a lot of things that we don't think we can make and we can handle. But Jesus said that we can do all things through Jesus Christ who strengthens us. There is not a battle that you'll face. There's not a trial you'll go through that God won't be able to help you through. I appreciate you. I take this as a great honor to stand before you this morning. And like I said, I don't preach funerals. He preached his own funeral. And when the family told me that he was a gentle soul, that makes it that much easier to stand before you today and say that he was like Christ and he represented who Christ is. I don't know your personal relationship with God this morning, just like you don't know mine. The Bible said to work out your own salvation. So I'm not going to stand up here and preach to you for 30 minutes on how to live your life when the Bible said to work out your own salvation. But I'll tell you this morning that Jesus Christ loves you and he died for you. And I'm here for you. If I can help you, if I can pray for you, if I can do anything for you this morning, I'm here. I love you and I appreciate you and thank you for having me. Thank you for trusting me enough to stand behind this podium and speak over Mr. Lee and how great of a man that he was to his family. I love you this morning. I appreciate you. We're going to close in a word of prayer. If you will, bow with me one last time. Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning, God, once again, thanking you, God, for this word. We thank you, God, that we are more than conquerors through you, God. Lord, we thank you that you said that if you're for us, who can be against us, God? We thank you for that this morning, God. We thank you that no matter what we go through in this life, you're always going to be there, God. Lord, we know this morning, God, that the enemy can throw his snares, he can throw his traps, and he can put us through the trials and tribulations of this world, God. We are overcomers by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony, God. And we thank you, God, that you made a way, God, that we can live, God. Lord, as you said in your word, God, that we can have life and have it more abundantly, God. We thank you for that this morning, God. I pray once again that you be with this family, God, in the upcoming days, weeks, and months, God. Lord, we just thank you for everything that you've done and what you're going to do, God. Just be with this family and give them the peace and comfort that only you can. And it's in your name we pray. Amen.